And digital payments is an area where you guys have been very active. Can you tell us just a little bit about what's going on there?
Well, roughly, its impact is massive. I mean, we're talking to operators in the healthcare industry, we're talking to mobile operators, we're talking to banks. I mean,
beyond banking?
Oh yeah, 100%. Because as you can tell from today's conference, for example, the payments world has expanded exponentially. And everyone and everything is trying to step into payments, whether retailers, typical fintech players.
Right. So as banks pursue their ecosystem strategies, their collaborations, you're following them and helping them connect to other players.
And I think the onus is on the banks now to try to bridge the gap and play catch up with all the modern technologies that are being provided by the likes of Google Play and Apple Pay, WePay.
And do you think they can? I mean, you've seen banks go through a lot of transformation, and you've helped them with some of those. What's the final step that you think that as a vendor you can help them to continue that path?
I think making it easy for them, at least from a technological perspective, to be able to look at that, because ultimately it's transactions. It's the bread and butter of what you've been doing for the last 40 plus years, right? So making its adoption easier, along with what's happening within the bank's internal operations and organizations in terms of simplifying willingness to unplug old heavy systems and let's go with what's new, what's global.
Right, so whether it's microservices, containerization, adding these sorts of things on top of the core legacy stuff, which they may not be able to get rid of so easily. Yeah, so more demand from institutions, buy side and sell side in Asia for the kinds of things that you can do to help them streamline their operations.
Exactly. And surprising for us, I mean, if I look at some of our newer technologies in AI and digital payments, the uptake in Asia has been much faster than in conventional markets.
Is that because the infrastructure that they're working with is not as good, it's not as developed, or it hasn't been around for as long, so they can leapfrog? Or is it just the mentality?
I think it's both. There's no heavy luggage like big institutions out in the US or Europe. And there are a lot of newer institutions coming out to the market here than elsewhere, right?
Right. Well, Haitham, thanks for taking some time to speak.
It's my pleasure.
Yeah, and thank you for watching. Please be sure to check out, we've got a few other videos in this special series from Singapore. For DigFin, I'm James DiBiasio.